Today, we are going to discover how you can create and manage WooCommerce product variations such as size, color, and brands. Then how to make these visually appealing and recognizable for your visitors in the front end. And then we are going to design our own custom single product page from scratch using Elementor. And by the end of this video, you will have a fully functioning product page where your visitors will be able to select any product by size, color, or any other attribute. Well, hello guys, my name is Dave from the Plus Addons for Elementor. Now don't forget to like and subscribe to our channel as we upload new Elementor videos each week, which will make you an Elementor master in no time. And also, feel free to share this with your Facebook community so that your friends can learn more about Elementor. Very good. So let's get started. And welcome to our WordPress dashboard. So from here, the very first step is to go to the plus settings, extra options. And from here, we are going to enable the WooCommerce swatches. So make sure to toggle that on, click save. Very good. So now we have an additional options that will allow us to create specific attributes. And to show you exactly what I mean, let's go to the products, attributes. And as you can see right here, we have a drop-down menu. And here you can select among three different options. You have color, image, and button. Now let's have a look at the default WooCommerce installation, which is this one. As you can see, this option is not available. So by enabling the WooCommerce swatches, you will have these additional options, which will help you to customize all your attributes fully. Now, as you can see by the side here, we have a few ones already that we've created. So the first one is a brand. As you can see, you could have Adidas, Nike, or Puma. Then you have the color, could be blue, red, yellow, and size as well. It could be small, medium, or large. So if we click on this one, for instance, as you can see, we have an image attached to it. Now let's go back to the others. We could have the color as well. So let's click on this one. And as you can see, this type here is color. So basically you can assign any of those three types, image, color, or button. So let's create this together. Let's start from scratch, okay? So let's go to a fresh WooCommerce installation here. And let's start with our first one. So let's go ahead with size, for instance, okay? So first you type in the name and then the slug. So the slug basically is everything that's going to show up after the trailing slash in your web address. So as you can see here, we have WP admin at the moment. But if you were in the front end, it would show yourdomainname.com/ and then the slug followed by some other information. So basically the slug is a unique reference for the attribute. So it shouldn't be more than 28 characters. That's all basically, okay? And now we need to select our type. So which type is it? We have color, image, and button. So let's go back to our front end here. I have a quick example here. So as you can see the size here, large, medium, extra large, and double XL. So the first one, clearly that's color. The second one, the pattern here, this is an image. So clearly the size would be a button. So let's go back here and let's select button, okay? Just like this. And now we can select a default sort order. So you can sort them by name, numerically, or by term ID. So that's really up to you. We can go by name for now. This is absolutely fine. So we can add our attributes now. And as you can see by the side, this has been created for us. And now we can configure our terms. So what are the terms? Well, basically it's small, medium, large, extra large, etc., etc., okay? So let's click on this. And let's add our first one. So the first one will be small. You don't always have to add a slug. It's really up to you, but you can as well, you know. So let's add small. And what do you want to display on the button? So this one will be just S for small, okay? So let's add new. And let's do the same with the other sizes. And there you go. Now we've added all our different sizes. So let's do the same now with the colors. So let's create a new attribute. So this one will be called color, the slug color as well. The type, it will be color. And now this ordering could be by name as well. You know, this is fine. So let's add the attribute now. And again, let's configure the terms. So let's click on this. And let's add our first one. So we would have black. And then we can select our color here immediately. So let's click on this. And let's select the black color. There you go. Add new color. Let's do the same with red. Let's select our color. Let's add the new color and yellow. Let's select yellow and let's add this. Very good. So now we've created three different colors. Now let's do the same with our brands. So we go back to attributes, brand, and this time this is going to be an image. And for the ordering, we can select by name as well. This is absolutely fine. And then we can add our attribute. And again, let's configure the terms. So let's click on this. So we said the first one was Adidas. Now we can upload an image. So let's click on upload an image. So we can see we've uploaded this already. So let's select the Adidas logo here. Use image. Let's add the brand. The next one, Nike. And we'll do the same, upload an image, select the Nike logo, use image, add new brand. And the last one was Puma, upload image, select the logo, use image, add new brand. There you go. So if you go back to our attributes now, as you can see, we've created three different new attributes by image, by color, and by button. Now again, just to reemphasize a practical tip here, when you add your name and slug, you don't always have to add a slug, because here when we added the colors, we didn't create any slugs at all, and yet they've been created automatically. So basically they will fetch the name and translate that into a slug. So just enter the slug maybe when you want the slug name to be different from your term. Okay, very good. And now that our attributes are created, let's go to the product section and let me show you how you can create a product and assign those attributes and use them for your variations. So let's create a new product. So let's call this one T-shirt. Okay, let's give it a small description. So this will be part of the T-shirt section, and we could add this in the fashion and designer section as well. So let's scroll down the page. Now we need to select the type of product. This is going to be a variable product, obviously. And then we can give it a short product description and also add an image. So this is the main image. So let's go maybe with a black color, set product image. And you can also have an image gallery. So if you want to display more than one image at once, you can select all the other pictures and add them to the gallery. There you go. Very good. And now let's take care of our attributes. So which attributes do you want to assign to this specific product? So this is a T-shirt. So clearly it will come in different sizes and colors and perhaps as well brands. So let's just assign size and color for now. Okay. So we just add the size, add. Very good. And now we can select the specific terms. So we could select small, medium, and large. And don't forget to tick the box here, used for variations. Okay. And now we're going to add the second one, which is the color. Add. And now in which colors does this T-shirt come in? Well, we have black, we have red, and we also have yellow. And again, we are going to use this for the variations. And by using this for the different variations, this will allow you to display different images once you click on those small icons here. So if I click on the blue T-shirt will show up. On the yellow one will show up. On the black one will show up. Okay? So this is basically how it will work. So you can assign a specific image per variation, and you can also have different price structure. And once you've added all your variations, you can click Save Attributes. And now we can add and create our different variations. So we click on the Variations tab. There you go. And as you can see, you have the option to create variations from all attributes, which is the easiest option. So let's click on this and let's click Go. So as you can see here, you get a warning message. Don't mind that. Click OK. Very good. And as you can see, 9 variations were added. So clearly we have large, medium, and small. And the large one comes in black, red, and yellow. The medium comes in black, red, and yellow. And the small one in black, red, and yellow. Now, if you expand all of these, you can expand all of them just at once. Now, as you can see here, you can add different pricing and also upload a different picture per product. So let's do this together now, just with the large ones. So let's add a picture. So this is black. And the price, let's say $19.99. Okay, so let's copy this for the next one. So we go to the large one in red. So let's click on this. We select the red image this time, set variation, and it's probably the same price as well. Now we go to the large one. This one is in yellow. So let's select the yellow t-shirt, set variation, and then we do this with the price. Now I'm going to quickly do that with the rest of the variations. So there you go, last one done, and now we can save your changes, just like this. Okay, very good, and now we can scroll back up on top of our page here and click publish. So don't forget to click publish, because this is very important, is to save your product page, okay? And now that our product is created, let me show you how you can add those swatches to your product page. And for this, we're going to use WooBuilder. So let's go back to our WordPress dashboard, and there are two methods actually to do so. So you can either use Next Builder and create a new template, or you can use Elementor Pro and create a template as well. Either way will work fine. For this tutorial, we're going to use Next Builder, and for this we go into All Templates, and on top here we can add a new one. So let's give this a title, so WooCommerce single page, for instance, and we need to select our layout. So this is a page, this is a single page, and now we can create our conditions. So this will be applied to all products. So let's select our products here. So let's scroll down. As we see, we have products here, so all products. There you go, this is our condition. And it will, again, we repeat this here for the preview. So this is all products. And we need to select one product for the preview as we work on that page. Okay, so let's select a t-shirt, for instance. So we can publish. And now we can edit with Elementor. And now we can start designing our page. So you can use flex containers or sections. That's really up to you. We're just going to use section here for now. Okay, so we're just going to add a first structure here. So let's go with this. And then within this, we're going to add an inner section. So on the left-hand side, we're going to add an image. On the right-hand side, all the information. And then we can add another structure again at the bottom, just underneath. And this will be only just one column. So we're going to delete this one. Okay. And there you go, one column. So this is for the tabs and additional information. So right here, we're going to add an image. So let's go to our widget, Woo Product Images. Let's add this there. Very good. And on this side, we're going to add all the information required. So the first information we need is the title or the name of the product. So let's look for this now. There you go. So let's add it here. So that's our title. So we can remove all the others. The reason why I'm doing this is because you have more control over it if you add the items one by one, and then you can customize them fully. Then we're going to add our Woo single pricing, and now we can drag and drop it underneath. Just like that. And again, we're just going to keep the information that we need, which is the price. So remove add to cart, remove stock, sold, and attributes. Next, we're going to add our product description. Next, we're going to add our add to cart, stock level, sold, and attributes. So again, we're going to use Woo single pricing for this. And for this, we're going to keep all the information except the price. So we can remove the price. There you go. So next, we're going to add our tabs here and additional information. For this, we're going to use Woo single tabs. So drag and drop, just like this. And then we're going to scroll on top of our page, and we're going to add a section here just to add a bit of breathing space. And right here, we're going to add a full width column, just like that. And we're going to add a little bit of a spacing on top. So let's add a spacer. And now we're going to add a breadcrumb as well. So just for navigation purposes. And then we can just drag and drop it here. And there you go. As you can see, in just a few minutes, we've created our own custom WooCommerce single page. So now let me show you in the front end what it looks like. And there you go. It looks absolutely great already. Now, obviously, you can customize every aspect of this page yourself, you know. But at the moment, as you can see, it is already operational and fully functional. So as you can see, we have, for instance, you can select the size, so large, maybe in red, in which case we will see the t-shirt in red color. Maybe I want a small one in black. Then we will see the black t-shirt, maybe medium in yellow. And there you go. So this is how this works. Now again, we have a dedicated video on how to customize every single aspect of your WooCommerce single page. And as always, we'll leave a link in the description below. Now we are open to your suggestions, and if your favorite feature is missing, then feel free to add it to our roadmap so that we can hear about your great ideas. And for this, simply go to roadmap.theplusaddons.com, and from there you can submit your suggestions. And we'd like to thank you in advance for your help and support. Again, if you liked and learned something new in this video, feel free to share with your friends in your Facebook communities and make sure to hit the like and subscribe button so that YouTube knows that you loved this video. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you guys in the next video.